Lillian Jarvis. Catherine Stewart.
Made it. And just in time, too. Tonight of all nights, opening night, is no time to be late. Not with the house packed to the gods and a full symphony orchestra and a real professional stage. The very same stage where Pavlova has danced. And the Ballet Russe and the Ballet Theater, using these very dressing rooms. All those famous professionals from London and Paris and New York. What are people who have seen them going to think of schoolgirls and stenographers from Vancouver and Winnipeg and Hamilton? Just amateurs from Toronto or Ottawa or Montreal.
On stage for still feed. On stage, everybody.
Almost curtain time. Suppose somebody falls or something slips in front of all those people. Suppose you forget what to do. Les Sylphides, one of the loveliest of traditional ballets by the company from Ottawa. For 200 eager, excited young Canadian dancers in 10 companies from 6 cities, it's the big moment. The climax of years of training and rehearsal, of hours and hours of hard, exacting work in lunchtimes and evenings and weekends. For 5 nights, Canada's first national ballet festival gives them professional conditions, a chance to show and learn what they can do. The Winnipeg Company presents an entirely Canadian ballet to music especially composed by Walter Kaufman. Visage.
Thank you.
Canadian Ballet. What did they think? They loved it.
Won't call for you, miss, from Montreal.
Backstage, there's the heady air of success as the festival goes into its second and third nights. Proud parents telephone to repeat the praises of theater critics.
Excuse me, c'est très pressé. Au pour ce soir, ça ira très vite, je te remercie. A bientôt, bonjour.
All over the country, newspapers are saying things like outstanding ballet, polished performance, thoroughly satisfying. The folks back home, even those who find little appeal in the ballet, are caught up in the general enthusiasm, proud of their success, and proud they should be, whether they're dance lovers or not. Hard work and determination and self-discipline are not the basic qualities only of good dancers. They're also the qualities of good citizens. And in dance after dance, all the week of the festival, these young performers demonstrate the qualities of both. Corn by Toronto's Volkoff Company to music by John Weinzweig. It's been a week of ovations for company after company. It's been a week of glamour and excitement and success for hopeful young dancers. It's been a week of achievement for their teachers who brought the discipline and the joy of the great tradition of ballet to Canada and whose dream it is to develop out of the Canadian character a distinctively Canadian dance, a professional Canadian company, and an appreciative Canadian audience. The festival is only a beginning, but it is a beginning, and a beginning to be proud of.